good afternoon. Today is Thursday, December 3rd, 2028. Yemen one step away from famine, as Donald dry up amid COVID. United Nations warns. Urgent alert in Sweden over million struggling with catastrophic levels of hunger as less than half of the required aid received. The window to prevent the return of famine to Yemen is rapidly closing. United Nations agencies have warned, with a new assessment showing millions could head further into hunger in the coming month. The alert came as the World Health Organization Food Security Assessment showed thousands of people are spilling into famine, a number that is predicted to triple in the first half of next year, while millions more have seen declining access to food. An estimated 16,500 people are now facing a catastrophic famine-like situation, which could increase it to 47,000 people by June 2021. The new figures were disclosed as aid agencies warned that less than a half of the emergency funds caused for the United Nations to help Yemen this year had been delivered. Last month, United Nations humanitarian chief Mark Lowcock told the United Nations Security Council that the $3.4 billion £2.5 billion appeal for 2028 for Yemen had received only $1.5 billion or about 45%. He said that by this time last year, the United Nations has had received twice as much, almost $3 billion. British Foreign Secretary Dominic Raab announced the additional emergency funds of £14 million for Yemen, which he said would take the United Kingdom's contribution to £240 million this year. According to the assessment released on Thursday, more than half of Yemen's population of 30 million risks split into worsening levels of hunger by mid-2021. According to the joint statement by the World Food Program, UNICEF and the Food and Agriculture Organization, the analysis warns that the numbers of the people facing phase 4 food insecurity, the emergency phase, is supposed to increase from 3.6 million to 5 million in the first half of 2021, which, without a change of course, will put the country on the precipice of famine. 5 years of war have exhausted the families and they left people acutely vulnerable to shocks. These alarming numbers must be a wake-up call to the world. Yemen is on the brink of famine and we must not turn our backs on the millions of families who are now in desperate need, said David Beasley, the World Food Program's Executive Director. Oxfam's Yemen Director Mushin Siddiqui said, "It's intolerable that millions of people in Yemen are one step away from famine and are struggling with catastrophic levels of hunger alongside conflict, COVID and cholera. And yet, donors have given barely half the money needed this year to provide the most vulnerable people with basic necessities like clean water, food and medicine. and the world grapple with the economic fallout of the pandemic, the international community should not forget the world's most vulnerable who urgently need life-saving help and should make every effort to ensure a peaceful solution to this conflict. The conflict in the Arab world's most impoverished nation began when Iran backed the Shia rebels, now known as Houthis, captured the capital of Sana'a in 2014, forcing the internationally recognized government to flee. The following year, a Saudi-led coalition supported the government intervened to battle the rebels and curb Iran's influence in the what has turned into a stalemate, a regional proxy war. Since then, more than 100,000 people, fighters and civilians have been killed. Make no mistake, 2021 will be even worse than 2008 for Yemen's most vulnerable people, added Basley. Famine can still be prevented, but that opportunity is slipping away with every day that passes. In recent months, Yemen has witnessed a significant drop in humanitarian aid as key Arab donor countries fail to fulfill early pledges. Cuts to humanitarian support this year, including food assistance, have erased the previous food security gain and left families with worsening food consumption gaps. The agency said next year cuts will continue and may be expanded unless funding is urgently received.
500 villagers live in Al-Matna on the outskirts of Hodeidah, Yemen's fourth largest city. They don't have proper homes. All they have are handmade huts or straw to sleep on, with no running water or electricity. Fatima lives here with her family, which receives less than $1.50 a day in government aid, just enough to afford a little bit of flour. Malnutrition is widespread because of food shortages, and diseases are spreading because infrastructure is destroyed. Fatima says the closest doctor is 30 kilometers away. If someone is sick, they're often left to die.
We don't earn enough to build a house or buy a house. Even the money is not enough to take someone to a doctor for treatment. Even if you have sickness, there's nothing we can do except pray to God.
The damage to water and sewage systems is helping cholera to spread. Humanitarian groups estimate almost 1 million Yemenis have fallen ill and more than 2,000 people have died of the disease. There are clinics in Al-Hudaydah governorate, but they lack funding and hygiene is poor. The clinic in Al-Zaydiyah town was funded by the UN until the end of last month.
We received more than 2,000 cases till now, including more than 950 cases in September. This medical center has been financed by UNICEF for only 2 months. Now we urge the concerned parties and the organizations to support the center because we need to take care of more cases coming to us.
With no funding, its future is in jeopardy.
The situation here is catastrophic. It was a shock for us to close this center. This is a crime. I urge all officials and humanitarian groups to come here and see these patients suffering. Seeing is believing.
The UN describes the war as a man-made catastrophe and says war crimes are being committed by both sides. That's a coalition of Arab and African countries led by Saudi Arabia, which backs the internationally recognized government. It's trying to defeat Houthi rebels backed by Iran and others. 2.5 years of fighting has killed 16,000 Yemenis, more than half of them civilians. And at least 18 million, that's the two-thirds of the population, need humanitarian assistance. Without it, many fear they won't survive, whether from famine, disease, or the continuing coalition airstrikes. Sinem Kösoğlu, Al Jazeera.
This is sad news. The famine in Yemen. Yemen suffered war, civil war, COVID. Right now, the famine. This image is, for me, is a sad image. I can't imagine the people in Yemen, all in different countries of the world, who suffer the famine. It's very, very sad. I hope que la international community can to help Yemen people. Right now, it must forget the war in Yemen, the different ethnic people, the Houthis or no Houthis, the rebels or no rebels. Right now, Yemen needs aid. Yemen needs us. We make part of the international community, so we must help that people. See, if you have food every day, think. Pass one day, no food, no clean water, only one day. And you can to understand, you can understand what these people is passing right now. In Yemen, in different countries in the Africa. See, if you have food right now, if you don't have food, you can understand, and you can need aid too. No, sorry, you need aid too. This year, 2028, is the worst year, the 21st century. But the next year, maybe the worst year in Yemen too. You must to do the difference. We must help our brothers, sisters. Thank you very much for watching this video. Share this video. Give it like, comment. I hope, I have hope in the human race. I have hope. Thank you very much. Good Thursday. I see you soon. with the other interesting news. Thank you very much. Good night.